हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू अवर चैनल लव ऑफ बायोलॉजी। प्लीज़ लाइक शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब अवर चैनल। टुडे वी आर डीलिंग विद बायोटेक्नोलॉजी एप्लीकेशंस इन एग्रीकल्चर। बायोटेक्नोलॉजी इज नथिंग बट प्रोड्यूसिंग द प्रोडक्ट्स फॉर ह्यूमन वेलफेयर बाय यूजिंग द लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स और देयर मॉलिक्यूल्स। इन एग्रीकल्चर बायोटेक्नोलॉजी इज यूज्ड टू इम्प्रूव क्वालिटी एंड क्वांटिटी ऑफ द फूड। Nothing but the green revolution, because day by day population is increasing, and also to reduce the chemical fertilizers which cause harm to us, make pest and insect resistant plants, and also to tolerate the stress conditions, to overcome any environmental changes. For these, the biotechnology is used to improve all these things. Transgenic plants, few examples, let us see. By using the RDNA technology in agriculture, first one is golden rice, BT cotton, flavor saver tomato, RNA interference or silencing. So one by one we will discuss about them. First coming to the golden rice. Golden rice, which is rich in vitamin A. So this transgenic plant is to improve nutritional value of the food to treat the night blindness, because it is enriched with vitamin A. By using RDNA method, vitamin A producing genes which obtains from carrot or any other thing. So those genes are inserted into the vector, nothing but the plasmid, and later inserted into the host rice plant, which will undergo transcription and translation and produces the vitamin A. So which is rich in vitamin A rice, nothing but the golden rice. So the method which we learn in RDNA technology that we use here to produce this golden rice, because efficiency of vitamin A leads the night blindness, to treat that. So nutritionally rich rice are producing. Next coming to the BT cotton, the cotton plants are infected by the insects which will damage it. So BT toxins produced by the bacteria, that is Bacillus thuringiensis, which produces cry proteins against the insects without using insecticides, because reducing the chemical use. These BT toxin genes will be inactive in a host as well as in the bacteria, but they will become activated in the presence of alkaline pH, which is present in the insect gut. BT toxin genes isolated and inserted into the vector, which introduced in the host plant. Insect infects the plant cells. These BT proteins bind to the gut of the insect where alkaline pH is there and get activated and make pores on its gut. Finally, what happens? The insect will be killed. So these cry proteins or crystalline proteins, which are in the inactive state in host and bacteria and activated only in insect, so they will kill. So it is acting as an insect resistant. So these transgenic plants are used. So not only in cotton, other brinjal tomato also this method is used. Next, flavor saver tomato. A transgenic tomato to increase the shelf life period by delaying the ripening process. Actually, ripening takes place in the presence of polygalactouronase enzyme. This gene is used for the ripening. Using antisense technology, we are going to inactivate this enzyme, making non-availability of the sense mRNA for the translation of the enzyme. If this enzyme is inactivated, what happens? The ripening process does not take place, because the sense mRNA absent, if unavailable, that does not produce this, because translation does not take place. See, galactouronase enzyme will soften the fruit by breaking the bonds in cellulose and making it soften. Increase the shelf life. This enzyme is inactivated. This is the antisense technology method. So this is a commercially important product. So next, coming to the pest resistant plant, that is RNA interference or silencing method. So here nematodes are the pest which damage the tobacco plant roots. So against this, we are using this method. Genes of parasite are inserted into the plasmid and later into the host tobacco plant, which undergoes protein synthesis and produces an enzyme called dizer or ribonuclease. This dizer or ribonuclease will cut the RNA molecules into fragments. When parasite is Malloid igni ignatia nematode infects the tobacco roots, the dizer breaks down the RNA into fragments, which are antisense sequences of the mRNA of nematode growth hormone gene. So what happens? These will bind with the mRNA of the nematode and form double-stranded RNA. Double-stranded RNA does not undergo translation. So what happens? So these RNA fragments acting as a RNA silencing or RNA interfering genes.